to grilio sion toria de dosa es praria da de dolore di andaria di barabashanta le kata kapra kate kete ko prokoto go prokoto lege de barabashanta lege dos pro lege sprogodu shata sprogodu shake sprogodu shata brogodu soto lege desha. Oh, Father, we bless your holy name. We worship you. Lord, we bless your holy name. We bless your holy name. We thank you for a new day. We thank you for a new day. We thank you for grace. We thank you for keeping us alive to see today. Manta kabra di satole gedo shata bragedisa. Oh, we thank you for grace to see another day. Father, we thank you for a new week. We thank you for a new week. We thank you for a brand new day. This is the day the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. Father, we just bless your holy name. We worship you. We give you all the glory. Hey, David said, I slept and I awoke because the Lord sustained me. Father, we thank you for sustaining us all through the night. We thank you for keeping us all through the night. We thank you because you did not let the enemy exert himself upon us all through the night. We bless your name for watching over us, for protecting us. We can sleep, but you don't sleep. Aren't you grateful that you sleep, but God doesn't sleep? Aren't you grateful that you doze off, but God never dozes off on you? Father, we are so grateful. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord, because he who keeps us neither sleeps nor slumber. Oh, we thank you, Father, because you watch over us 24/7. We are so grateful because we can see today because you watched over us. We thank you because we are alive now because you preserved us all through the night. Somewhere right now, somebody is crying. Why? Because somebody did not wake up. But we woke up. We thank you, Lord, because we are alive today. In somebody's house right now, there's wailing and there's mourning. Why? Because someone refused to wake up this morning. Father, we thank you because we are awake. We thank you because we are not just awake, we are alive and well. We are alive and well. We give you glory. We give you praise. We give you all the honor. Thank you, Father. Come on, thank him. Father, we thank you. Father, we thank you. Father, we thank you. Because we are alive and well. There is no wailing. There is no mourning in our homes. Thank you, Father. Our children are sleeping well. Our spouses are sleeping well. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Because you've watched over us. You've kept our livestock. You've kept our home intact. You've kept everything that concerns us. Father, we just bless your holy name. Come on, thank him. Thank him. Thank him for the privilege to see another day. It is by his mercies that we are not consumed. Hey, Father, we bless your holy name. I'm not better than the person that didn't wake up this morning. You are not better than the person that didn't wake up this morning. So thank God. Thank God for your life. Thank God for your life. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father, for the gift of life. Every day you have to breathe, it's a gift. Every day you breathe, it's a gift. The air you breathe is a gift. Father, we thank you for the gift of life. Father, we thank you for the gift of life. Thank you for the air that we breathe. I believe none of you are on oxygen. Oxygen is very expensive. Come on, thank God that you can breathe in and breathe out. Father, we just bless your holy name. We thank you for the grace that you have given us to breathe in and breathe out free from charge. Lord, we thank you, Lord. We thank you, Father, that we're not hooked to an oxygen machine. We thank you, God, Lord. We thank you, Father. We thank you for good health. We thank you for sound mind. We thank you, God. We thank you, God. We thank you, Father. We thank you, Father. Have you gone to visit people in the hospital before? Have you gone to General Hospital? I used to go there to preach. When you come out with a renewed sense of gratitude that you are alive and well, that you gave birth and nothing evil happened to you. You are just so grateful on another level, a new sense of gratitude, a renewed sense of gratitude that this is an opportunity. It's not your right. It's a privilege that you're not hooked in the hospital. It's a privilege. It's not your right. It's a privilege. So, Father, this morning, we just thank you. We are so grateful for the gift of life. We are so grateful for the gift of life. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father, for keeping us all through the weekend. All through the weekend, we bless your holy name. We worship you. We give you all the glory. Hallelujah. Father, we exalt your holy name. We bless your holy name. We thank you, God. We thank you, God. Now, ask for the grace to pray. Ask for the grace to pray this morning. Lord, we receive grace to pray. We receive strength. We receive grace. We receive utterance this morning. In the name of Jesus, none of us will be tired. We will not be weary. We will not sleep off. In the mighty name of Jesus, get up from your bed. I'm walking and pacing up and down right now. Get up from your bed. Walk, pace up and down. Let all protocols Bashanta. It is good to exercise yourself spiritually. We are about to exercise ourselves spiritually. Jump up from your bed. Come out of your room and pray. Lord, we ask for supernatural grace this morning to pray, to move things in the spirit. Hey, Father, we thank you. The Bible says if you give any offering, if you are giving every offering at the altar and you remember that your brother or your sister has something against you, or you remember that you are holding somebody in your heart, you have a grudge against someone, hey, Jesus said, leave your gift there in front of the altar and first go and be reconciled to them. Before we pray, I want you to release anybody that has hurt you, anybody that has hurt you, be it your spouse, your friend, even your nannies. I want you to release them. Just release them. Let them go. Let that person go. Say, Father, I let this person go. I forgive my husband. I forgive my friend for what she did to me over the weekend. I forgive this person. I forgive that person. I let them go. Why? Because they will hinder your prayers. They will hinder your prayers. Offense is very expensive. You can't afford to hold offense or hold a grudge against someone. You are a spirit-filled person. It disconnects you. It just cuts you off from fellowship with God. The minute I walk in offense, I know that I've been cut off. I know it's automatic. I just know that I've been cut off from the fellowship with the Holy Spirit. I just know it. So this morning, before we pray, I want you to look into your heart and release anyone that has hurt you. Release anyone that has hurt you. Just love on them. Father, I let this person go. I let this person go. I let this person go, that my prayers will not be hindered. I just love on them. I send them the love of God. I release them from my heart. I release them from the bottom of my heart. In the name of Jesus. Oh, Father, I let them go in the name of Jesus. I release them. I release them. My prayers will not be hindered. Whatsoever it is that will hinder my prayers this morning, Father, Lord, be it offense, Lord, I release it. I let them go. I forgive. I forgive and I forget. I forgive. Help me to forget. Help me to forget in the name of Jesus. Father, we just bless your holy name. Father, we decree and declare that our prayers go unhindered this morning. In the name of Jesus, our prayers go unhindered this morning. In the name of Jesus, the accuser of the brethren, we silence you this morning. In the name of Jesus, we silence you this morning. In the name of Jesus, in case you are raising allegations against us, we bring it under the blood. Bring it under the blood. In case the enemy is raising allegations against you in the spirit realm, Father, we bring it under the blood. We bring it under the blood. Every accusation, we bring it under the blood. In the name of Jesus, the Bible says, be alert and of sober mind. Your enemy, the devil, he prowls around like a roaring lion, looking for who to destroy. Another version says, looking for someone to devour. Hey, kato bradis la kato, be alert. Be alert spiritually, because the enemy, your enemy, Satan, is always on the move. Always on the move. Therefore, Father, we secure our perimeters with the blood of Jesus. We secure our lives again with the blood of Jesus. Come on, reinsure your life in the blood of Jesus. I reinsure my life in the blood of Jesus. I reinsure my health in the blood of Jesus. I reinsure my business in the blood of Jesus. I reinsure everything that concerns me in the blood of Jesus. Because I'm aware that the enemy is going up and down, seeking whom to kill, to steal, and to destroy. Lord, this morning I reinsure everything that concerns me in the blood of Jesus. Bring yourself under the blood. Hey, Father, from the crown of my head to the soles of my feet, I dip myself in the blood of Jesus. I decree over my life, no evil shall befall me, neither shall any plague come near my dwelling. In the name of Jesus, Father, this week I walk in safety. I dwell in safety. I go in peace. I return return in peace. In the name of Jesus, Saloto, Prakoto, Lezisa, Prakate, Luso, Luso, Enkroto, Palisa, Paria, da Bashanta, E Krado, Soto, Credia, Basika, Pradia, Satalia, E Kroto, Bolika, Paria, da Basika. Psalm 91 says, He shall give His angels charge concerning me to keep me in all my ways. Father, I decree and declare every day of this week, my angels are in charge of my ways. My angels are keeping me. My angels are watching over me. They are on guard 24/7. In the name of Jesus, no evil shall befall me. I will not dash my foot against the stone. What does that mean? It means your car is not permitted to bash anybody. Nobody is permitted to bash your car. Lord, it is written concerning me that my angels, they bear me up in their arms, lest I dash my foot against the stone. Rekato brokoto lizi kelesto progedishka. O trailer is permitted to run into you. That is the meaning of that scripture. Lekrozuso progodush kelekte kodiye de basanta. So Father, I decree and declare concerning my life that I go in peace and I return in peace. I cancel every agenda of Satan concerning my life this week. Today, I cancel it. I tear it apart. It will not come to pass in the name of Jesus. It shall not come to pass in the name of Jesus. It shall not come to pass in the name of Jesus. Loto preketali gadoshe ezete kurodusu progia lakato repeto repeto preketuzo pronto eskele gadosha. Some of you are saying, is Satan always planning something against me? Yes, he is. Yes, he is. He's always at work. He's always on your matter, whether you like it or not. Hakoriya bashanta is always on your matter. That's why the Bible says, watch and pray. Watch and pray. Be alert. Be alert. Be alert. Look stupid, but be alert. Just be alert. How can you be alert? Be alert in prayer. Be alert in prayer. So this morning, I want you to resist the devil. I want you to resist the devil. Satan, I resist your plans concerning my life. I resist your plans concerning my business. I resist your plans concerning my family. In the name of Jesus, the Bible says, resist him and he will flee from you. In the name of Jesus Christ, I come against every agenda of Satan concerning my life, concerning my business, concerning my going out and my coming in. In the name of Jesus, it will not stand. It will not come to pass. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. E kabalo satoriye de bashanta e kreto zuso progadiga lagadosi enzete krutuba enzete krutuba. The Bible says in Job chapter 1 verse 6, it says there was a day the sons of God came to present themselves before the Lord, and guess what? Satan came also with them. Reto proto kolisa paria de bashanta. He came with them. There was a day that children rose up to pray and present themselves before God, and the devil showed up among them. And God was talking to him. He said, where are you coming from? What have you been up to? He said, from going to and fro in the earth. Open your Bible, Job 1 verse 7. It says, from going to and fro in the earth and from walking up and down in it. That's his job. He's always roaming about. If there's an open door, he will enter. If there's an open door in your house, he will enter. So today, I want you to shut the doors again. Against him. Father, I shut the doors against Satan. In the name of Jesus, I shut the doors of my business against him. I shut the doors of my health against him. I shut the doors of my marriage against you, Satan. In the mighty name of Jesus, Satan himself, he answered God. He said, from going to and fro in the earth and from walking up and down in it. Job 1 verse 6 and 7. Go and read it. Let Krotoba Shikataria de Basanta. He said, Ketoli Gebrondo is Kaprolia Galustataria de Basanta. What is he looking for? He's looking for where he will sit. He's looking for where he will gain entrance. He's looking for who he can destroy. He's looking for who he can steal from. When he sees you happy, he is sad. He's just depressed. Why must you have children? Why must you be married? Why must you be blessed? Why must everything go well for you? That is his job, to oppose you. To oppose you. Now I want you to resist him. In the name of Jesus, Satan, I oppose you concerning my life. I oppose you concerning my business. Concerning the works of my hand, I oppose you. In the mighty name of Jesus, concerning my marriage, I oppose you in the name of Jesus Christ. My day is blessed. My day is blessed. My week is prosperous. The works of my hands prosper on another level this week. In the name of Jesus Christ. I want you to secure your marriage in the blood of Jesus. The four walls of your marriage. Hey, I cover my marriage in the blood of Jesus. It is written, now, what God has joined together, let no man put asunder. Hey, Satan, whatsoever agenda you have concerning my marriage, you don't have to wait until something is wrong or until you are fighting or there's a quarrel before you pray for your marriage. You can pray up. You can pray in advance. Stay prayed up. Stay prayed up. Satan, whatsoever agenda you have concerning my marriage, I resist you in the name of Jesus. Every timetable that you have set for me, every timetable that you have set for my family, for my marriage, for my husband and I, Lord, I come against it by the blood of Jesus. I wipe it away. I wipe it away. I erase it. Every agenda, I erase it in the name of Jesus. Every agenda, I erase it in the name of Jesus. Pray for your spouse. He will not die, but he will live. A weapon formed against him shall prosper. We will not raise money for kidney transplant for him. We will not raise money for cancer. We will not raise money for any sort of treatment for your spouse in the name of Jesus. I just cover my husband in the blood of Jesus. I cover him in the blood of Jesus. I call to prekete liga dosia eskalogodush kapraga esketo liga rosia e prekete lugo lugo brenga eskatoria de bashanta. In the name of Jesus, no evil will befall him. No plague will come near his dwelling. I refuse every bad phone call. I reject it in the name of Jesus. Every phone call that will call me and say, hey, something has happened. Is this Mrs. so-so-so? And so I reject it in the name of Jesus. Ekopolo sotoria da shanta. Only good news will come my way this week. Only good news will come my way this week concerning my spouse. Only good news. Only good news in the name of Jesus. I will not be a widow. Lekopoto rika para tashikata. E prakato lizete lizete. Regusto pregodo shikaparia da baseka. E kroto liso liso pronye liso liso pronye. Perhaps your husband is going through financial tough times. He's going through a hard time in his business. I want you to pray for him this morning. Lift his business before God. Prata is Katolika Boshe. Oh, Father, I just pray for my husband's business, Lord. I ask that your blessings will be evident upon him this morning. I ask that you give him guidance, direction. I ask that you give him revelation. I ask that you speak to him concerning the works of his hands. In the name of Jesus, I rebuke the devourer concerning his business. In the name of Jesus, I rebuke the devourer. I shut the mouth to the devourer concerning my husband. Business in the mighty name of Jesus, in his in his office, in his career, Lord, he will advance in the name of Jesus. He will not be frustrated. You know, sometimes men go through a lot, and some they don't share with us. That's why it's important to cover him in the place of prayer. Father, I just cover my husband with the blood of Jesus. Let your peace surround him. Let your peace surround him. Let your peace surround him in the mighty name of Jesus. He will not seek comfort in the wrong place. He will not seek peace in the wrong things. Lord, let your peace garrison in that, oh God. Grant him divine direction. In the name of Jesus, grant him divine direction. This week, Lord, do something good for my husband. Do something new for my husband. In his business, give him a testimony. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the works of his hands, give him a testimony. In the name of Jesus. Make him happy, God. Give him a miracle. For my sake, Lord, give him a miracle. Give my husband a miracle in his finances. Give him a breakthrough. Give him a breakthrough in the name of Jesus. Lord, we just cover our spouse in the blood of Jesus. Mato preka lusa praga disa lokate rekoto bushka bushka leva sitoria eskalegedo sopronda likto koria de bashanta. Lord, we pray for our children. Lord, we bring them before you. The Bible says our children shall be taught of the Lord. You don't know the depth of that statement. Father, let my children be taught of you. When I'm there, when I'm not there, let the fear of God teach my children. In my absence, let the fear of God teach my children. Bring your children before God. Mention their names. I pray for my firstborn, my second, and my lastborn. I cover them in the blood of Jesus. Oh, Mareta Kobara Bashanta. Every agenda of Satan concerning my children, Lord, I destroy it completely in Jesus' name. I come against it by the blood of the Lamb. It will not stand. In the mighty name of Jesus, Sato Prakati Ligedose, Iskoroba Shataka, Regudusu Pronde Eskelegedosia. Oh, Father, I cover my son in the blood of Jesus. I cover my daughter in the blood of Jesus. I decree and declare no harm is permitted to come near them. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, no harm is permitted to come near them. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. circumstance. You might have CCTVs all around your house, but God is your divine protection. The Bible says, except the Lord watches over a house, the watchman wake up in vain. They stay awake in vain. Father, I ask that you watch over my children by day and by night. Give your angels charge concerning them to keep them in all their ways. They're on holidays now. Lord, I ask that your preservation, your banner over them remains love. Your preservation will never depart from their life. In the name of Jesus, no nanny is permitted to do them wrong. No nanny is permitted to do evil to my children. In the mighty name of Jesus, no gate man is permitted to look at my children with evil eyes, with any evil intention. In the name of Jesus Christ, Lord, we cover our children in the blood of Jesus. We cover our children in the blood of Jesus. No childminder, no caregiver is permitted to come near them and harm them. In the mighty name of Jesus, no abuser is permitted to touch our daughters. In the name of Jesus, we secure them in the blood. We secure them in the blood of Jesus. Recuto, precoto, ligadosia. No lesson teacher is permitted to abuse our children. In the mighty name of Jesus, we secure them in the blood of the Lamb. Recto prokoto ligedosia, opakate legeduso, pronda askite legedosia, reketo vasika. Our children will be taught of the Lord. Even when they're on their iPads, they'll be taught of the Lord. Hey, they will not watch the wrong things when we're absent. In the mighty name of Jesus, why the fear of the Lord will garrison their hearts. Father, baptize our children with the fear of God. Baptize our children with the fear of God. Let them hear your voice at a very young age. The Bible says God called Samuel at a very young age. Father, let our children hear your voice at a very young age. Let Asha, Anna hear your voice at a very young age. Mention their names. Let Aaron hear your voice at a very young age. In the mighty name of Jesus, Sato Preketi Legadosia, Iskatoria Vasante, Eshkoto Vesi, Koleborundo, Superindi, Aloto, Ikrondo Bosoto, Korea de Basanta. Holy Spirit, teach our children. Speak to them. Help us. Cover our shortcomings. In the name of Jesus, we are not perfect parents, but help us, Lord. Help us to be good to these children. Help us to teach them. In our absence, help us, Lord. In the mighty name of Jesus. Now I want you to pray for your house, the building you are living in. I want you to commit your house into God's hand. Lord, you said there shall be no breaking in or breaking out. I cover my house in the blood of Jesus. There shall be no fire outbreak. There shall be no domestic accidents. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, no evil shall befall my house. No thief is permitted to come near my building. In the name of Jesus, I release ministering spirits to stay and stand their guards, to watch over my house by day and by night. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, leko prokore katalia barabasanta, ijeteke legodosi, kranda asprunde, seleduse, ikroto. Can you imagine how many times armrobbers have driven past in front of your house? Armrobbers have driven in front of you. Can you imagine how many times? You have no idea what God is doing for you. Father, Lord, concerning my house, this very house that I live in, no evil is permitted to come here. In the name of Jesus, I cover my doorstep in the blood of Jesus. I cover my gates in the blood of Jesus. Hide my house from the wicked one. Hide my house from thieves. Hide my house from assassins. In the name of Jesus, they will not enter my house mistakenly. They will not enter my house mistakenly. In the name of Jesus, I don't know why we're praying like this. Just hide your house. I hide my house in the blood of Jesus. Ekoto balasikata reketo brekete leketo. If maybe thieves are being chased or policemen are chasing them, they will not enter my house to hide. In the mighty name of Jesus, I forbid you. In the name of Jesus, Sato Prokotila Gadoshe, they will not enter my house. Nobody will be held ransom. In the name of Jesus, nobody will be taken captive. In the name of Jesus, I cover my gates in the blood of Jesus. Thank you, Father. I'm seeing an angel stand on my roof. I'm seeing an angel stand right in the center of my roof. And I believe it's happening for everyone as you pray right now. Lord, give your angels charge. We release our angels to stand their guard, to watch by day and by night. To tell the enemy, not here, this is not your house. We shut the gates of our house by the blood of Jesus. We shut the gates of our house from armed robbers, from thieves. We shut them out in the name of Jesus Christ. There will be no conspiracy against us. There will be no conspiracy against us. In the name of Jesus, our staff will not conspire against us. In the name of Jesus, you have heard how people's chef, they butcher them. They make arrangements for thieves to break into their house. Father, you said surely they will gather, but their gathering is not of you. Wherever they have gathered concerning us, concerning our house, Lord, we destroy their gathering. In the name of Jesus, Sato Preketi Legados, Rempe, Rempe, Iskolok Tokoria Bashanta, Edekelek Tokoria de Sikata. Lord, we destroy their gathering. Every evil conspiracy against us, against our house, wherever they have marked our house, Leko Poko, Keta Ligadosia, Ekotof as their next place of operation. Lord, we confuse them in the name of Jesus, be it spiritually or physically. We confuse them in the mighty name of Jesus. We send confusion and darkness their way. In the name of Jesus, Kapole Sete Rigadosia. I'm still seeing that angel. He's standing in the middle of her. Oh, thank you, Holy Ghost. He's standing on my roof. Oh, Paleta, as you pray, your angels are taking their position. As you pray, your angels are taking their position. Why did I tell you that? So that you can know that when you speak, you give your angels charge. You give them authority. They don't assume that you need help. They move when you speak. They are not trained to assume you need help. But when you pray, they take charge. They move. This morning, we take charge concerning our houses. We cover our houses in the blood of Jesus. We cover our homes in the blood of Jesus. Nobody will wake us up in the middle of the night to take off our clothes. We reject it in the name of Jesus. Oh, we cover every daughter, every female daughter in our house. We cover them in the blood of Jesus. The enemy is not even permitted to come in. He's not permitted to come in the mighty name of Jesus. We receive safety. We receive protection, divine protection. We receive protection over our houses in the mighty name of Jesus. There shall be no breaking out or breaking in my house in the name of Jesus. Father, we bless your holy name. We worship you. I want to pray for everyone that is working in one organization or the other. Maybe you are working in one office or the other. And they have conspired against you. They have gathered to sack you. They have gathered to put you in trouble. They have gathered to just do something wrong for you. We send confusion their way in the name of Jesus Christ. False allegation, we cancel it concerning your life in the name of Jesus. We cancel false allegation concerning you in your workplace in the mighty name of Jesus. Some people don't know that they are planning against them at work, but when you pray, because you showed up this morning, God is uncovering their plans. God is uncovering their plans. He says, surely they will gather, but not by me. Whosoever shall gather together against you shall fall for your sake. Isaiah 54, verse 15. In the name of Jesus, whosoever gathers against you in your workplace, in your office, in your business place, they fall for my sake. In the name of Jesus, open your mouth and pray. They fall for my sake in the name of Jesus Christ. You said no weapon formed against me shall prosper, and every tongue that includes false allegation in your workplace, false allegation, every tongue that shall rise against me in judgment, thou shalt condemn. This is the heritage of the servants of the Lord, and their righteousness is of God. Father. I condemn every tongue that rises against me in the boardrooms. I contend with them. I condemn them and I contend with them in the name of Jesus Christ. If you are working in an office, you need to pray this prayer point. We condemn them in the name of Jesus. Every tongue that will rise against us will speak ill of us when we are not there to defend ourselves. We condemn it in the name of Jesus. Father, you said it will not stand. Their words will fall to the ground. It will not hold water in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Repeto, likroto, brakata, jeti, koposeti, kalato, ikroto, vasita, legdo, shikopronda, iskalogodu, basanta, ebele, ebele, kumbra, iskataligadosia. The Bible says when a man's ways pleases God, he makes even his enemies to be at peace with him. Father, we pray concerning our enemies in our workplace, those who hate us that we don't even know they hate us. Lord, cause them to be at peace with us. Cause them to be at peace with us in the mighty name of Jesus. Maybe you just did one little thing and your boss just disdains you. He just hates looking at you. But because of one mistake, Father, let favor speak for me in the sight of my boss. Let favor speak for me in the sight of my peer groups, in the sight of my colleague. Let favor speak for me in the mighty name of Jesus. In the sight of my HR, Lord, let favor speak for me in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Let croto brisita kalubose ikradobolo boshikate ibranda liketoria da santa ikefeteliso pronga esketelegedoshi. Lord, we speak favor over our lives, favor in the job, favor in your career, favor in your office, in the name of Jesus Christ. Supernatural favor that recommends you for training abroad. Supernatural favor that recommends you for promotion. Supernatural favor that recommends you for a raise. Oh, we receive that favor in the name of Jesus. Father, grant us supernatural favor. In our office, in our job, in our career, wherever it is we work in. Lord, supernatural favor in the name of Jesus Christ. If there's anyone that's trusting God for direction concerning the career, receive direction now. Receive illumination. Receive revelation. Receive divine direction in the name of Jesus Christ. You are trusting God. You don't know if you should apply for a job. You don't know, maybe you should leave where you are. You don't know what to do. Lord, I pray for divine direction. I pray for divine direction concerning my career, concerning my job. I pray for direction. I pray for illumination. In the mighty name of Jesus, Father, open my eyes. Speak to me concerning this job. Speak to me, God. Speak to me. Where should I apply? Where should I send my CV to? Should I step out? Is it time for me to leave where I am? Lord, speak to me. Give me divine direction. Open up my heart and speak to me, Lord. Cause me to hear your voice. Try my reins in the night time, Lord. Give me visions and dreams in the night concerning my career. Lord, give me direction. Order my steps in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I will not walk in my flesh. I will not walk in my own understanding. If you are in business, I want you to raise your business before God this morning. Cover your business in the blood of Jesus. Lord, I cover Protect One in the blood of Jesus. Mention your business. I cover it in the blood of Jesus. It is written concerning me, that whatsoever the righteous man doeth shall prosper. Therefore, I decree over my business, prosperity is your portion. Prosperity is your portion. In the name of Jesus, concerning the works of my hand, be it trading, buying or selling, whatever services you render, prosperity is your portion. We invoke supernatural favor. We invoke irresistible favor over our businesses right now in the name of Jesus. Irresistible favor over our business. We invoke it by the blood of Jesus Christ. The favor that makes us the preferred one. The favor that makes my business the preferred one. Lord, come, let it come upon my business right now. In the name of Jesus Christ. Maybe you have been counting thousands as prophets. This week we open you up for hundreds of thousands. In the name of Jesus. This week open your mouth. Call forth orders like never before. I open up my business in the mighty name of Jesus. I decree and declare orders come for my business from the north, east, west, and south in the name of Jesus. My business is the preferred one. My services is preferred. My services are preferred in the name of Jesus. Atoke protole gusto guste e credobo listoria de bashanta e kafaria da sotoko. I decree this week sold out is my portion. Fully booked is my portion. In the name of Jesus, sold out is my portion. Fully booked is my testimony. In the mighty name of Jesus, the Bible says you shall decree a thing and it will be established unto you. Are you decreeing? Are you opening your mouth? Oh, I decree concerning my business, sold out back to back. Maybe you just received new goods. I decree in the name of Jesus, before Friday, it will be sold out. It will be sold out in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Hey, Satan, I rebuke you in the name of Jesus. Don't touch my business. Hey, the fire of the Holy Ghost consumes any finger that you have raised over my business in the mighty name of Jesus. Hey, brother Basanta, as you pray for your business, close your eyes and imagine clients. Imagine customers trooping in and out. There is no space to sit down. Imagine your phone just buzzing. Hey, I need this. I need that. I need this. I need that. Just imagine it and pray it. Pray it. Close your eyes and pray. Pray concerning what you are seeing right now in your business. Pray concerning it. Oh, I see it. I see it. In the name of Jesus, I see people calling my phone by day and by night. The Bible says your gates shall not be shut continually. No, no, no. It will be open by day and by night. Why? That the Gentiles may come in, that their kings may be brought. Lord, I decree and declare this week, kings and queens of the land, they require my services in the mighty name of Jesus. They choose me. They choose my business. They choose my business in the name of Jesus. When they're looking for people to render my service, so the kind of service I render, Lord, they choose me. They choose me in the mighty name of Jesus. On social media, divine announcement. Divine announcement. Beyond your sponsored ads. Let angels go now and put my business in their faces. Let angels go now and put my business in the faces of people. In the name of Jesus, in the mighty name of Jesus, I decree and declare concerning my goods and services, sold out, fully booked is my testimony this week in the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, we cover our business with divine favor. We cover the works of our hands with divine favor. In the name of Jesus, you will not walk in debt. You will not run on a minus. In the name of Jesus, perhaps you are owing someone. Hey, we pray for divine favor. You will not run in debt. Quarter to shame, the Lord will show up for you in your finances. In the name of Jesus, let's pray concerning our finances. Lord, we bring our finances before you. You know our account balance. You know what everyone is going through. Everybody needs money. But there are some people that need money now. There are some people that need money desperately. There are some people that if God does not come true for them, they will see shame. Father, if you are here, Lord, I join my faith with you this morning. For everyone that is dying, is in dire need of a financial help, financial breakthrough. Father, we join our faith together. The Bible says, if two shall agree, you have me in faith. You have my agreement with you this morning. If two shall agree as touching anything here on earth, our Father in heaven will do it for them. Lord, I join my faith with my sister. Lord, this morning in the name of Jesus, that this financial breakthrough, this desperate financial help she needs, will come through speedily in the mighty name of Jesus, that they will not see shame in the name of Jesus. I'm hearing rent. I don't know if it is your shop rent or your house rent, but your rent is due. And you don't even know where you're going to get the money to pay. It is coming from. I join my faith with you this morning. Help comes from you. Help comes for you in the name of Jesus. David said, I look up to the hills. From whence cometh my help? My help comes from the Lord who makes heaven and earth. He will not suffer my foot to be moved. Hey, I join my faith with you and we call for financial help. This morning, financial help for your daughters in the name of Jesus. For everyone represented on this prayer line, hey, we call for financial help. For my life, financial help. For their lives, financial help. In the mighty name of Jesus, let their finances begin to come together. Let it begin to come together. That woman's rent is paid by a miraculous intervention. I agree with you that your rent is paid. Your rent is paid in the name of Jesus Christ. The Lord will show up for you. The Lord will send helpers to you in the mighty name of Jesus. Helpers of destiny. Destiny helpers. They will come for you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Lord, we call forth help from the north, east, west, and south. One order that will take care of all your bills. Just one order that will take care of all your needs. Oh, Father, we call for that order in the name of Jesus. We call it forth. It comes forth speedily in the mighty name of Jesus. Sometimes when you ask God for money, it comes in form of work. So Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, we call for the type of work that will sort out every pending bill for every woman here this morning. We call it forth in the name of Jesus Christ. Rekato brakato ledu soporia da bashanta. In the mighty, are you calling forth? I call forth others in their millions, hundreds of thousands. I call it forth from the north, east, west, and south. They come to me now in the name of Jesus Christ. Repetolia, repetolia, escotoligedose, credosusa, pradesi laboshe, eprecato, divine expansion over the works of my hand in the name of Jesus. Apori catoligedoshe, ikratova, ikratova, lecrutubosotoko, eprecatelicato, zicate, macrotobalicato, that which was not enough becomes more than enough now in the name of Jesus. Prophesy over your life. I step into my season of abundance. I step into my season of more than enough in the mighty name of Jesus. Concerning my finances, this week I enjoy more than enough. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I will not finish spending one before I get another. In the name of Jesus, I step into my season of more than enough in my finances. In the name of Jesus, more than enough to pay my bills. When I finish paying my bills, I will still have some money left. In the mighty name of Jesus, there's somebody here, when you pay your bills, there's nothing left. I decree over your life this week that from today, you step into your season of more than enough. In the name of Jesus, lekroto paraka telegedosia. You step into your season of more than enough in your finances. In the name of Jesus, you have more than enough to give. You have more than enough to give. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Father. There are people here who are trusting God for business ideas. You are trusting God for business ideas. Perhaps you already have an idea and you don't know which way to go. You don't even know how to start. The Bible says in Job 32 verse 8, it said there is a spirit in man. The breath of the Almighty gives him understanding. Another interpretation says there is a spirit within man. The breath of the Almighty within them, it makes them intelligent. The NIV translation, it says that spirit makes you intelligent. That spirit, God, it gives you light and understanding. It shows you which way to go. Makoto preketa ligadosia. Oh Father, we pray concerning everyone with a new business idea. Oh proto ligadosia kete, that your Holy Spirit within them will begin to give them intelligence, a divine direction, supernatural wisdom. You will show them the way to go. Yekopolo kuto paragadiska. Oh, how to start it, where to start from, which step to take. Receive direction in the name of Jesus. Receive illumination in the mighty name of Jesus. Open your mouth, Lord, concerning this business idea. Lord, I want to start it this month. I want to start it next month. Give me divine direction. Give me divine direction. There is a way to enter into the city. The Bible says the labor of fools weary them. Yeah, for they don't know where to, which way to go into the city. Oh, your labor will not weary you. Why? Because you are awake to pray this morning. You will not labor in vain. You will not toil in vain. Some of you, you have done so many businesses. Your husband does not even believe in you anymore. He says you have come again. He just keeps giving you another chance. Hey, but this time around, this business idea will flourish. This one will yield profit 100-fold in the name of Jesus. You will not work at a loss. Receive understanding. Receive illumination in the mighty name of Jesus. Your friends already know you. Every day you come up with something new. You are not stable. The Bible says he that is unstable in his ways cannot receive anything from God. Receive stability in your business in the name of Jesus. Father, help me to be stable. Help me to stay this one through. Help me to watch it. Help me to stay through this business. Help me to withstand. Help me to stay through this business in all seasons. In the name of Jesus, give me a lasting idea, a lasting business idea, a lasting business idea. Rakoto prokoto ligedo shekete. Ebradu satariye de basanta. Ideas that will pay my bills. Ideas that will pay school fees when my husband is down. Ideas that will pay rent. Ideas that will pay us, send us out of debt. Lord, bring those ideas my way. In the name of Jesus Christ, show me the way into the city. How do I break into this market? Father, give me divine direction. Give me illumination. The Holy Spirit is your creativity. He is your creativity. He will tell you how to do it better. I tell you, we have not exhausted all the ideas that are in God. We have not even exhausted 10% of it. There is more. Ideas rule the world, but God rules ideas. He owns those ideas. So therefore, God rules the world. You are a child of God. You have access to divine ideas. You have access. You are not permitted to sit down idly, folding your hands, doing nothing. The Bible says the idle mind is the devil's workshop. Oh, trust God for divine ideas. Ideas that will bring you out of poverty. Say, Father, I'm tired of begging. I'm tired of going about looking for money to pay my bills. Lord, give me an idea that will save my life, that will bring my family out of poverty. In the name of Jesus Christ, an idea that will restore my dignity. In the name of Jesus Christ, an idea that will restore my respect in my home, in my friends. Give me ideas, oh God, that will break through financially. In the name of Jesus Christ, open up my heart. Speak to me. What can I do, Holy Ghost? What should I do? Give me divine direction concerning my business, concerning a new business idea. Lord, give me direction. Trust God for divine direction. Be alert. Be sensitive. He will tell you what to do. Open your mouth and pray. Pray in the Holy Ghost for 1 minute. Mazata kalegadosh. Riketo bradias katoligadosh. Riketo bregadosi at kaligadosia. Holy Spirit, I thank you for business ideas. I thank you for new ideas that will set me free from poverty. Riketo loboshikata. Is gatalegadoshke. Roktosko pregadosh kataligadosia. There's nothing as liberating as seeing what you like and being able to afford it without stressing, without pulling out your hair, without contemplating. There is nothing as liberating as that. God wants to give you that kind of freedom, financial freedom. Freedom to give without being afraid that my account balance is red. Freedom to give, freedom to so, freedom to be a blessing. Lord, I want to be a blessing. Lord, give me new ideas. Give me business ideas, Lord. Show me the way to go financially in the name of Jesus Christ. Lord, we thank you. We thank you for divine direction. Oh, there's a spirit in man. That spirit lives on the inside of you. That spirit resides in you. In the name of Jesus, you have understanding. You have light. You have divine direction. In the mighty name of Jesus,
Tala is a Tala. Lord, we bless your holy name. Hey, Krotobolo do Soporia de Bosha, Macrede, Lusa, Lusa, Apragedosia, Rekitova, Sikalecta, Ikredoshe, Rapataligedose, Krunda, Afrekedo, Kuraba Santa. Hey, Lord, this week we receive the grace to pray, the grace to be consistent, to show up and pray. Tomorrow, receive the grace to wake up by yourself and pray at 5 a.m. Hey, set your alarm. Tomorrow, you will wake up and pray. Even if it is for 30 minutes. Lord, I receive grace to be consistent in my prayer place this morning, this week. In the name of Jesus, I receive grace to be consistent. This week, I will be spiritually alert like never before. In the name of Jesus, I will not be distracted. Lord, baptize us with fresh zeal, fresh fire. We will not be lukewarm this week. In the name of Jesus, we will be on fire by day and by night. Ekoto bala sikato rapito reporto liketo jekete lengro askoto ligedosia ikreto bologodosi kabaradia soto. The Bible says Jotham became mighty. 2 Chronicles 27:6. It says Jotham became mighty. Why? Because he prepared his ways before the Lord is God. Ekato bala gadasia. When you wake up to pray, you prepare your way before God. And you're supposed to do it on a daily basis. You're supposed to be consistent with it. Why? Because the instruction you received yesterday might not work for you tomorrow. The instruction received on Monday might not work for you on Thursday. So you need to prepare your way before God. This is the secret to greatness. The secret to greatness is to wake up in the morning and prepare your way before God and set your week. Set your week before God. Say, Father, go before me. Open your mouth. Go ahead of me into the week. Every crooked path, Lord, let it be made straight. Every rough road, let it be made smooth. In the name of Jesus, let every mountain, every hill be leveled. Let it be made plain before me. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, every hurdle ahead of me, every obstacle ahead of me in this week, I overcome it in Jesus' name. I overcome it in Jesus' name. In the mighty name of Jesus, Father, go before us into this week. Cause every crooked path ahead of us to be made straighter. Let every rough road be made smoother. In the mighty name of Jesus, we shatter every limitation. We overcome every hurdle, every obstacle. We jump and pass. In the name of Jesus, reketo brekati legadosia iskete legado. Prepare your way before the Lord. Lord, I receive grace to prepare my way before you every day of this week. In the name of Jesus, in the place of prayer and Bible study, Lord, I will be consistent. I will be consistent. In the name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus, I will be consistent in my prayer, in my walk with you this week. In the name of Jesus, do you know you can be in the spirit today and be in the flesh tomorrow? Say, Father, this week, I will be led by your spirit 24/7. Every day of this week, my steps will be ordered by the Lord. I will not start in the flesh on Monday. And by Friday, I will not start in the spirit on Monday. And by Friday, I'm 100% walking in the flesh. No. This week, every day of this week, my steps are ordered by the Lord. I choose to prepare my ways before God. In the name of Jesus Christ. Reketo brakilekotosia ishketeva ligedosia krende askotoria de bose repeto pretegelese poria de bashanta. In the name of Jesus, Lord, baptize us with the grace to be consistent. In the mighty name of Jesus, the grace to be consistent in our walk with you, in our prayer life. In the name of Jesus Christ, let grado Supradosi lakatosia, ikredal historia, strengthen every feeble knee. In the name of Jesus, we come against the spirit of discouragement. You are discouraged. You keep saying, I've been praying for the past 1 week, and this thing has refused to move. We come against the spirit of discouragement. In the name of Jesus, receive courage on the inside of you. Receive courage on the inside of you. In the name of Jesus Christ, you will not be discouraged. This week you will follow through. You will show up to pray. Every day of this week, you show up to pray. You wake up to pray. By night you are praying. In the morning you are praying. Receive grace and courage. In the name of Jesus, even in the midst of this thing you are going through, receive grace and courage to pray. Hey, tell yourself, God is good all the time. Whether he does it or not, my God is still good. My God is still good. I will pray and I will praise him. I will pray and I will praise him. Father, this week, no matter what comes my way, I will pray and I will praise you. This week, no matter what comes my way, I will pray and I will praise you. Give me strength. Give me courage on the inner man. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Oh, Father, we bless your holy name. Rekutopo, Shikita Ligadosi, Efreketiso, Poligadosia, Embregadu Shikaria, the Basikelecto, Iska Fragaduska, Paria de Bosotokoria, Doshikata, Rikato, Bragadiska, Lacto Coria de Bashanta. Oh, Father, we thank you. Lord, fill us up again. Fill us up again, Lord. New wine, fresh baptism, oh God. Fresh oil. Let it come upon us this morning. Anoint us afresh this morning. Ask for a fresh anointing this morning. Lord, anoint me afresh this morning. Ekoto galisa praga iskete legedushke makrato pregisa prekete legedosia. Fill me up afresh. Fill me up again this morning, Lord. In the name of Jesus, fill me up with your spirit. Baptize me, oh God, with your spirit. In the mighty name of Jesus, we are not permitted to run on empty this week. Legrados, Sikrados, Satalig, the Korea de Bashanta, Ikredose, Cabradiso, Legredosia. Father, baptize us afresh with the Holy Ghost. Baptize us afresh with the Holy Spirit. Let your hand be upon us like never before. Let your hand be evident upon us, oh God. Let your light shine over our lives, oh God. Let your glory radiate through us this week, oh God. In the name of Jesus Christ, anyone we come in contact with, Lord, they come in contact with your glory. Anyone we hold, they hold your glory. Anyone will touch, they touch your glory. Anyone will hug, they hug your glory. In the name of Jesus, Lord, let your glory radiate over our lives. Let your glory radiate over my life. From the crown of my head to the soles of my feet. Increase your light over my life. Increase your light over my life. In the name of Jesus, let your light dispel every darkness in my mind. Every darkness in my life. Every darkness, every gray area. Hey, light be. Concerning this situation, light comes in the name of Jesus Christ. The Bible says, arise and shine, for your light has come, and the glory of the Lord is risen upon you. Oh, this week I arise and shine. My light has come, and the glory of the Lord rises upon me. Every minute, the glory of God increases in my life. In the name of Jesus Christ, this week will be better than last week for me. In the name of Jesus Christ, in my business, prophesy over your life. This week will be better than last week for me. In the name of Jesus Christ, for the path of the righteous shines more and more. It shines brighter and brighter, even unto the perfect day. Therefore, I decree over my life. Hey, my path shines brighter and brighter. In the name of Jesus, I will not have a better yesterday than today. In my life, in my marriage, in my ministry, in my prayer life, in my business, my path shines brighter and brighter. In the name of Jesus Christ, I will not be a byword. In the name of Jesus Christ, are you praying? I refuse to be a byword. I will not be a proverb in the mouth of people. I decree over my life. I'm an eternal excellency. The Lord has made me an eternal excellency, a joy of many generations. Rokopote ligedose, iskete lagadoshe, kapalika, eprekitolia, santa, igedoshe, ratuda, pray in the Holy Ghost for 1 minute. Radioso, iklodoso, progodoshe. Lord, I'm praying for my life. Makrete ligedosia, iskete ligedosia. Holy Spirit, help me to pray concerning my destiny. Reteko, zetuka, prekata, ligedoshe, iskete valikto, korea de basantaria, microdo osto korea de basikelekte, isteru de bosoto prodia lakte korea mashata, karina osotoko. Are you praying for your destiny? Ekroto ligedosia, my path shines more and more. Ekoto rapatole, kaprodia sataka ligedoshe kete. I will not be a byword and a proverb in the mouth of men. In the name of Jesus, the enemy will not rejoice over my life. In the name of Jesus, katolege duse prega digelosia, ekrodolotiko progada. Everyone that is waiting to hear bad news concerning Olabisi, they are disappointed. In the name name of Jesus. The Lord disappoints them. In the name of Jesus, are you praying for your life? Are you praying for your destiny? My path shines more and more in the name of Jesus Christ. This is just the beginning. This is just the beginning concerning my life. This is just the beginning. More testimonies for me in the name of Jesus. More testimonies for my life, for my family, for my business. More testimonies in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, we just bless your holy name. We give you all the glory. We thank you for answers to prayers. We thank you because you don't stop prayers. You answer prayers. Lord, for this reason, we are grateful. For this reason, we are grateful. We thank you, God, because this week, is a fantastic week for us. This week is a fantastic week for me. I don't know about you, but this week, testimonies upon testimonies. The Lord makes a way for me where there seemed to be no way. This is my portion this week, and so shall it be for you. In the name of Jesus Christ, speak over your life. Lord, I thank you because you are making a way for me where there seems to be no way. I thank you because, Lord, you are making room for me in high places. I thank you, Lord, because this week doors open of their own accord for me. In the name of Jesus Christ, I thank you because the hearts of men are receptive towards my business. In the name of Jesus Christ, I thank you because the hearts of men favor me. In the name of Jesus, I decree and I declare over my life that strangers will favor me this week. My friends will favor me this week. People will favor me this week. Both old and young, they favor me this week. In the name of Jesus, I thank you, God, because this is my experience, and so shall it be. Lord, I thank you for the grace to prepare my way before you this week. I bless your holy name. I know that I will prepare my way before you tomorrow. I thank you, God. I thank you in advance for grace. Some of you are going to run in the spirit this week. You are going to run. You are going to run in the spirit. You are going to be consistent. An unusual fire is coming upon your life this week. In the name of Jesus Christ, some of you are going to finish the book of Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. You're going to lock yourself up and you're going to be praying. You'll be studying like never before. In the name of Jesus Christ, so shall it be for you. In Jesus' mighty, precious, awesome, beautiful, powerful, amazing name, we have prayed. Amen. Amen. Amen and amen. Oh, Father, we just thank you. Whew, hallelujah. That was amazing. I feel so refreshed. I feel so strengthened. I feel like whatever comes my way this week, I have overcome it already. I don't know about you, but that's just how I feel. I'm so grateful to God for grace to pray every day. You know, I'm just so grateful to God. This week is going to be a blessed week for you in Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you for showing up. Give me just 1 minute. 1 minute. I want to share a word with you briefly. Briefly, just a word with you. Just to exhort you and just encourage you in your walk with God. Acts chapter 16 from verse 6. It says, now they were gone throughout Phrygia and region of Galatia and were forbidden of the Holy Ghost to preach. Let me reduce this volume. Oh, thank you, Holy Ghost. Acts 16 from verse 6. It says, now they were gone throughout Phrygia and the region of Galatia and were forbidden of the Holy Ghost to preach the word in Asia. Verse 7, after they were come to Mysia, they are said to go into Bithynia, but the Spirit suffered them not. And they, passing by Mysia, came down to Troas, and a vision appeared to Paul in the night. There stood a man of Macedonia and prayed him, saying, come over into Macedonia and help us. And after he had seen this vision, immediately we endeavored to go into Macedonia, assuredly gathering that the Lord has called us for to preach the gospel unto them. What we see here is a clear sign of how God leads and directs his children. Do you have the Holy Ghost in you? Yes, you have the Holy Spirit. If you're born again, you have the Holy Spirit. The Bible says they wanted to go and preach in Asia, but the Holy Spirit said, no, don't go. They wanted to go to Mysia. The Spirit said, no, don't go. They were going to do something good. It wasn't bad. Every good idea is not godly. It's not everything that is good that God wants you to jump on. The Holy Spirit, he forbade them. He said, don't preach in Asia. Don't go to this place and preach. And then a vision came to Paul in the night. And a man came from Macedonia and said, come over and help us. That's divine direction. How do you receive divine direction? I want to encourage you this week to listen to the voice within. The Bible did not tell us how the Holy Ghost forbade them. But there was something on the inside that just restricted them. He just held them back. They wanted to go, but there was just this pullback. Listen to the voice within. It's going to save you from heartache, save you from loss, save you from accidents, save you from losing money. Some of you have embarked on business ideas that you didn't wait on God. You didn't get that green light from God. You didn't wait to hear that signal. There's a knowing on, the Bible says there's a spirit in man. A spirit, that spirit is the Holy Spirit. The more you listen to those little directions, just those small restrictions here and there, the more that voice becomes clearer for you. The more that voice becomes more audible, you begin to hear him the more. I want to encourage you this week, listen to the inner voice. There's a voice speaking on the inside of you, woman of God. Please listen, be yielding. Learn to obey that voice. It's not something talking to you. Don't say something told me. It's the Holy Spirit that is leading you. He's not something. He's a person. And if you're born again, he lives on the inside of you. So I want to encourage you this week. There are some steps you might want to take. On Friday night, my husband called me. He said, dress up. Let's go for a party together. I said, okay, no problem. I'm even dressed. I still look nice, you know. I was happy. But as soon as I hung up, I just felt a restriction. I don't know why. I just felt a restriction. Something just said, don't go out. I don't know why. I don't know why God just told me not to go out. But the Holy Spirit said, don't go out. Don't go. I called my husband back. I said, I don't know why. I just lost my mood. I just lost my mood. I don't feel like going anymore. He said, is everything okay? I don't know what it is. I just lost my mood. I was excited a few minutes ago. I put on my slippers. I was getting ready to just drive out and meet you up because he was at work and he just wanted me to meet him at work. And then I'll park my car and we'll go together in his own car. And when we're coming back, I'll pick up my car from his office. But I just felt that restriction. Why? Till now, I don't know. God does not owe you an explanation. Did God explain to Paul why you shouldn't preach in Asia? No. He just forbade him. We must learn to yield to the Holy Ghost. I don't know what God saved me from. Maybe if I had left the house, just maybe something bad would have happened to my baby. Or something was going to happen to me on the road. This is just me speaking, you know. I don't know why, but there was this restriction. So listen to that inner voice on the inside of you. He's always talking to you. He's always speaking. The Holy Spirit is always telling you what to do. The more you listen, the more the voice becomes clearer. God bless you. Go into this week and be in the Spirit. Every day of this week, you can live in the Spirit. You can live in the Spirit. We are not who we see right now. You are a spirit. You live in a body. So let that Spirit lead you. Let the Holy Spirit lead you. Let the Holy Spirit direct you. Amen. Thank you for indulging me. I don't know why. I just felt led to share that word. God bless you. Have a wonderful day. Remember, we are fasting today. Remember, we are fasting today. I didn't mention this last week, Monday, and it was deliberate because we have spent the whole week praying. The week before, we were fasting and we were praying. So I just thought, let me just give them a break, you know. But today, we are praying and we are fasting. You're going to spend time studying the word. You're going to spend time singing and worshiping God, spending time in the Spirit. So please receive grace. Receive grace to resist food, to resist bread, butter, whatever it is. Just shut the door to your kitchen and receive grace. You have prayed already, so you have strength to wait on God this week. God bless you. Have a wonderful day. Goodbye for now.